In this video, we are going to see game theory by using graphical method. See, some games will be a specialized nature like 2 into n games and m into 2 games. See, 2 into n games means the payoff matrix of the 2 into n games will contain 2 rows and n columns, whereas m into 2 games will contain m rows and 2 columns. Okay. In this video, we are going to see 2 into n game along with the problem. In the next video, let us see this one. Now, let us see the algorithm for graphical method along with the problem step by step. Look at the problem. Graphical method for 2 into n game. Consider the payoff matrix of player A as shown below and solve it optimally using graphical method. So this is the payoff matrix of player A. Player A has got 2 strategies and player B has got 5 strategies. And this is the outcome, that is payoff matrix. Now we need to find whether the game has got a saddle point or not. For that, just find out the row minimum and column maximum and find out maximum value and minimax value. Okay, look at the first row. Minimum value is minus 6. Row minimum minus 6. Second row, minimum value is minus 9. Among these value, which one is highest value? Minus 6 is the highest value. So this one is called maximum value. In the same way, find out column maximum. In the first column, maximum value is 3. In the second column, 2. Third column, 7. Fourth column, 4. And fifth column, 8. Among these value, which one is least value? 2 is the least value. So this one is called minimax. Maximum value minus 6 is not equal to minimax value. Minimax value is 2. Okay, maximum value minus 6 is not equal to minimax value, that is 2. Okay, so this problem has no saddle point. So here they are following mixed strategy. Look at the algorithm. The first step is reduce the size of the payoff matrix of player A by applying dominance property if it exists. See, this step is not compulsory. Even without reducing the size of the payoff matrix also, we can proceed the problem. But in order to simplify the procedure only, we are reducing the size of the payoff matrix by applying dominance property, that too if it is applicable. Okay. And after that, you can go to the second step. Look at the problem. The first step is checking dominance property. What is the rule for dominance property to reduce the column? Okay, the selected column value must be greater than or equal to any other column. Then the selected column is dominated by other column. Okay, so as we discussed in the previous video, just find out the total value of each and every column in order to reduce the column. First column total is minus 1. Second column minus 7, third column 12, fourth column minus 2, fifth column 14. Among these values, which one is highest value? 14 is the highest value. So now I'm going to compare these value with the other column value. So let me start from the first column value. Minus 4, 6, yes, higher value. 3, 8, yes, higher value. So this particular column is dominated by first column. So delete this particular column. What is the next highest value? 12. So now I'm going to compare this value with the other column value. So again, let me start from the first column value. Minus 4, 5. So highest value. 3, 7. 7 is the highest value. So this particular column again dominated by the first column. So delete this particular column. What is the next highest value? Minus 1. So now I'm going to compare these values with the other column value. Minus 4 is lesser than 2. So no dominance. So compare the last option. Minus 4 is higher than minus 6. 3 is lesser than 4. So no dominance. What is the next highest value? Minus 2. So now I'm going to compare this value with the other possibilities. Minus 6 is lesser than minus 4. So no dominance. See the other option. Second column is there now. Just compare. minus 6 is lesser than 2. So again, no dominance. Now see the last option, minus 7. So 2 minus 4, yes, higher than minus 4. Next one, minus 9. So minus 9 is lesser than 3. So no dominance. See the last option, minus 6, 2. Yes, 2 is greater than minus 6. 4, minus 9. So minus 9 is lesser than 4. So no dominance. That's all. So with the help of dominance property, we reduced 2 columns. Now we can proceed with the 2 rows and 3 columns. After the column reduction, this is the reduced payoff matrix. Now you need to apply the second step. Look at the algorithm. Step 2 is, let X be the probability of selection of alternative 1 by player A, and 1 minus X be the probability of selection of alternative 2 by player A. Look at the problem. See, player A has got 2 strategies, strategy 1 and 2. Okay, now for the first selected strategy, the probability will be X. Okay, the probability will be X for the first selection, okay, of the strategy by player A. For second strategy, 1 minus X. These are the probabilities of selected strategy of 1 and 2 by player A. Okay, with this probability, we are going to find out the expected payoff function for each and every alternative which B has got. Okay, again I repeat, we need to take X as the probability of the selection of first strategy by player A, and 1 minus X be the probability of selection of second strategy by player A. Look at the algorithm. Okay, X be the probability of first alternative, and for second alternative, 1 minus X, okay, by player A. And with this, you need to derive the expected gain function of player A with respect to each of the alternatives of player B. Okay, B has got 3 alternatives, no? Okay, with for each and every alternative, we need to find the expected gain function of player A. With this probability, we are going to find out the expected payoff function for the 3 alternatives which B has got. See, look at the table. Expected payoff functions and expected gain of player A. Okay, in this table, we are going to enter the expected payoff function in this column, and we are going to find out the expected gain of player A. Okay, according to the 3 different alternatives which B has got. Okay, look at the problem. What are the 3 alternatives of player B? 1, 2 and 4. In the first column, write the B's alternative. 1, 2 and 4. Now you need to find the A's expected payoff function with the help of A's probability of selection of 1 and selection of second strategy. See, for the first strategy, okay, you need to multiply the probability values with the first column value. Minus 4 into X plus 3 into 1 minus X. In the same way, multiply these value with the each and every other alternatives. For the first alternative, okay, minus 4x plus 3 into 1 minus X. For the second alternative, 2 into X minus 9 into 1 minus X. B second alternative is 2. Okay, so 2x minus 9 into 1 minus X. Look at the problem. The third alternative is fourth strategy. So minus 6 into X plus 4 into 1 minus X. So A's expected payoff function is minus 6X plus 4 into 1 minus X. Now with this equation, you need to find out the payoff function. Just simplify. Minus 4x plus 3 into 1, 3, minus 3 into x, 3x. So, minus 4x plus 3 minus 3x. What is the function here? Minus 4x plus 3 minus 3x is equal to minus 7x plus 3. In the same way, for the second alternative, 2x minus 9 into 1, 9. Okay, minus into minus plus 9x. Okay, so 2x minus 9 plus 9x is equal to 11x minus 9. In the third equation, minus 6x, okay, plus 4 minus 4x is equal to minus 10x plus 4. Okay, these are the A's expected payoff function. For the first alternative, minus 7x plus 3. For the second alternative, 11x minus 9. For the last alternative, minus 10x plus 4. Now we need to find the A's expected gain. Let us see the algorithm. Look at the algorithm. Now we have derived the expected gain function of player A with respect to each of the alternatives of player B. Now we need to find the value of the gain. Okay, when x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1, assume x is equal to 0 and find out the value of the gain. At the same time, assume x is equal to 1 and find the value of the gain. Okay, let me show this calculation. Look at the table. Now, just assume x is equal to 0 and apply this value in the payoff function and find out the expected gain. Okay, when x is equal to 0, what will be the gain? 3. When x is equal to 1, what will be the gain? Minus 4. For the second alternative, assume x is equal to 0. So, 11 into 0, 0, then minus 9. When x is equal to 1, okay, x is equal to 1, what will be the answer? 11 into 1, 11 minus 9 is equal to 2. In the same way, for the last alternative, x is equal to 0, no. So, minus 10 into 0, 0 is equal to 4. When x is equal to 1, so 10 into 1, 10 minus 10 plus 4 is equal to minus 6. So, these are the A's expected gain when x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1. Okay, we have applied these value in the A's expected payoff function and we have got the expected gain for A. Now with these values, we can plot the graph. Look at the algorithm. The next step is plot the gain function on a graph by assuming a suitable scale. Okay, see, keep x on x-axis and gain on y-axis. Okay, we have two gains now. When x is equal to 0 and when x is equal to 1. Okay, let us see this along with the problem. Look at the graph. Okay, this one is x-axis now. So, keep x on x-axis and expected gain on y-axis. So, here we have two gains now. When x is equal to 0, these are the gain. And when x is equal to 1, these are the gain. Okay, so y-axis will be gain, expected gain of player A. Now, let us see the lines. Look at the table. Okay, see, A is expected gain when x is equal to 0. What is the value? 3. When x is equal to 1, the gain is minus 4. So, this is the first alternative. So, in order to draw the line, just take this value. When x is equal to 0, value is 3. When x is equal to 1, the gain is minus 4. This line for x is equal to 0 and this line for x is equal to 1. X is equal to 0. What is the value? 3, no. 3. Okay, when x is equal to 1, what is the value? Minus 4. Now, just draw the line. This line represents A's expected payoff function. Okay, when B select the first alternative. Look at the second alternative. When x is equal to 0, what is the expected gain of A? Minus 9. When x is equal to 1, the gain is 2. Okay, x1 is equal to 0, the value is minus 9. So, minus 9 here. Okay, when x is equal to 1, what is the value? Plus 2. Just draw the line. This line is B1. So, this line represents A's expected gain when B select the first alternative. Okay, this one is B's second alternative, that is B2. Okay, so this line represents A's expected gain when B select the second alternative. Let us see the third option. When B select the fourth strategy, A's expected gain when x is equal to 0 is 4. When x1 is equal to 1, the expected gain is minus 6. Now, draw the line. Okay, this line represents B4. That is, when B select the fourth strategy. Okay, this is the third alternative. Now, let us see the algorithm. Look at the fifth step. Now, find the highest intersection point in the lower boundary of the graph. Okay, so now you have to find out the highest intersection point in the lower boundary of the graph. Since player A is the maximum player, so we need to find out the maximum point, that is a maximum of minimum. So we need to find the lower region. Okay, shade the lower region and find out the highest intersection point. So that point is called maximum point. Look at the graph, name the intersection point. Here intersection point is there, no? So A, this point is B, and this point is C. Now shade the common region which is below the boundary and find out the highest intersection point. So that point is called maximum point. So this is the common region which is below the lines. Okay, see, since A is the maximum type player, okay, identify the highest intersection point in the lower boundary of the graph. Okay, the lower boundary consists of the intersection point A, B and C. Okay, out of these three points, point B is the highest level. So this intersection point is called maximum point. Now see the algorithm. After finding maximum point, the next step is just check if the number of lines passing through the maximum point is only 2. Again, I repeat, if the number of lines passing through the maximum point is only 2, form a 2 by 2 pair of matrix and go to step 8. That is, you can solve the problem by using oddments and find the strategies for player A and B and also value of the game. This will be the final solution. Okay, if you couldn't find only 2 points, then you have to go to the 7th step. Let us see along with the graph. See, if in the maximum point, if the number of line passing through the maximum point is only 2, okay, in this problem, according to this problem here, this point intersect 2 lines only. Which line? B4 and B2. Okay, so this maximum point intersection point, okay, passing through 2 lines, one is B4 and B2. So we can form 2 by 2 pair of matrix from the original problem and we can proceed further. If we find more than 2 lines, there you have to see the other option. For that, look at the algorithm. See, if you find more than 2 lines, then you have to follow step 7. Identify any 2 lines with opposite slopes passing through that point. Then form 2 by 2 pair of matrix. I will explain this particular scenario, okay, in the other video, where m number of rows and 2 columns. But according to this problem, we have got only 2 lines which passing through the maximum point. Now with this 2 point, you can form 2 by 2 pair of matrix and proceed further. See, according to this problem, okay, the maximum point intersect 2 lines. One is B2 line and another one B4 line. Now we can form 2 by 2 pair of matrix from the original problem, taking B2 and B4 alternatives. Look at the last step. Solve the 2 by 2 game using oddments and find the strategies of player A and B and also find the value of the game. Okay, now we have formed 2 by 2 pair of matrix. Now we can proceed to find out the oddments and we can find the strategies of our player A and B and we can find the value of the game. Okay, this step you already discussed in the previous video. Look at the problem. With the help of graphical method, we have selected the maximum point at B2 and B4. So now we are going to form 2 by 2 pair of matrix, taking 1 and 2 for A and 2 and 4 for B. See the 2 by 2 pair of matrix. Now we can proceed the problem with the help of this matrix. The first thing is find out the oddments. Find out the difference between the first row and enter against the second row, and find out the difference between these two values and enter against the first row, which is called as oddments. 2 minus minus 6, you'll be getting 8. 4 minus minus 9 will be 13. In the same way, find the difference between these two values and enter against this particular column, and find the difference between these two values and enter against the first column. Okay, so 2 minus minus 9 will be 11 and 4 minus minus 6 will be 10. Okay, after finding the odd man's, now we can find the probability. Okay, 13 divided by 13 plus 8. For second option, 8 divided by 13 plus 8 is equal to 13 by 21. 8 divided by 13 plus 8 is equal to 8 by 21. In the same way, find the probability for column also. Okay, for column, the probability is 10 divided by 10 plus 11 is equal to 10 divided by 21. For second option, 11 divided by 10 plus 11 is equal to 11 divided by 21. These are the probabilities. So probabilities for player A and B. For player A, okay, strategy 1 and 2, no. For the first strategy, 13 by 21. For the second strategy, probability is 8 divided by 21. These are the probabilities of a player A. For player B, okay, he is going to select the second strategy and fourth strategy. Okay, for the remaining strategy, probability is 0. For the first one, 0. For the second one, 10 by 21. Third strategy is not there, no. So, put 0. For the fourth strategy, 11 by 21. Fifth strategy is not there, no. So, put 0. These are the probabilities of player B. Now, find out the value of the game. In order to find out the value of the game, take the first column as base. Just find out like this. 2 into 13 plus minus 9 into 8 divided by 13 plus 8. Again, I'll explain. Okay, 2 into 13 plus minus 9 into 8 divided by 13 plus 8. 2 into 13 plus minus 9 into 8 divided by 13 plus 8 is equal to minus 46 divided by 21. This is the value of the game. Okay, this is the procedure to solve the game when we have two rows and n columns. Okay, hope you all understood this concept. Thank you.